What's up guys, how are you all doing? Welcome back to another video. So today we have the Redmi 9 Pro as you can see, and in this video we'll be looking at some of the features that it has to offer. Now this may also apply to other Redmi phones which has MIUI 12 version. Now there are so many interesting features that you can utilize to the fullest so that you can customize your phone just like as you want, right? So that's what we'll be looking in this video, some of the features, because there are so many features that the video goes on lengthy. So that's why I'll be making some series of videos about the features, or rather tips and tricks about the Redmi 9 Power. In general, MIUI 12. So if you have MIUI 12 version on your Redmi phone, so all these settings or tips and tricks will work on your phone. So if you like these kind of videos, give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to click on that subscribe button for more content such as this. All right guys, here you have the Redmi 9 Power, and the first thing we are doing is going to settings, and here you'll see additional settings. Now there are so many things that you can actually do here. Now there is one useful feature which we don't see often. So here's the clear speaker feature. What this does is, let's say just by mistake you have put your phone into the water, right? Then the like literally water enters to the speakers first. So that's why when it enters speaker and when you try to play something after you have like dried up the phone, then the problem with the speaker comes up first. And what you have to do is to just enable or switch on this one. Then it plays a 30 second audio clip very loudly, meaning everything, the dust or something that's hidden inside those speaker grills will pop out. So that's how it helps clear the speaker, and this is an additional or rather nice feature I would say, which comes in handy whenever you have your phone like splashed with water or some dust enters the speaker especially. You can just go ahead and use this feature to clear those things. The second one is inside notifications. Now there is lots of things that you can do with the notification related thing, and you can customize just the way you want. Let's say with the lock screen, like if you don't want some apps to show up on the lock screen, its notifications, you can just literally go ahead and turn them off. Let's say you have some annoying notifications keeps popping up on the lock screen all the time. So if you just don't want to see that, what you can do is just go ahead, go to that app and turn off the notification. Next time you won't see the notifications of that particular app on the lock screen. So that's how you can customize. Similarly, you have with the floating thing here. So if we swipe down, what you see the notifications over here, you can control it over here. Let's say you don't want some notification from this bubble story, I can just go ahead and turn that off. Now if I tap on this application, particular application, you'll get whole bunch of features again. You can customize, like if you don't want the notifications with the sound, you can just go ahead and switch off. If you want the sound, you can turn it on, meaning you can customize a lot of things right here. So it's just with the floating again. Floating notification is this one, what you see notification here. You can control the individual apps, which apps to show notification, which apps you don't want to allow. Similarly, you have the badges for the applications. Like there are small badges over here, as you can see, 5, 1, meaning there are 5 notifications related to this application which are unread. So similarly, if you don't want that thing to happen or that thing to show up, so just go ahead with the settings here and you can turn that off, right? So the notification badges won't appear. Again, when you want to turn it on, you can just go ahead, swipe down all the way. Here it will show what are the apps that has like switched off with the notification thing. You can just go ahead and turn them back on. So this is how you can control the notification. There is again notification shade here, which means the shades, which is the like the cards, how it appears, how you want to customize. MIUI version has got a little bigger cards with more information. Like if I swipe down, as you can see the icons and cards. With the Android default thing, you have, see with the MIUI, if I just go ahead, so this is the kind of thing it appears with the Android. So with the default Android, it appears like a stock Android notifications, right? So if you want the new control center of the Xiaomi, what you have to do is go to the control center and status bar here, and here you will find use new control center. If you turn this on, look at the notification bar right now. So this is the kind of thing that appears, like iOS devices, so sort of. So this is the new control center of the Xiaomi. So you can enable this one. If you don't want that, you can just go ahead and turn it off. Again, a nice feature there, customizable. So that's again a nice thing of having an Android phone. So the another thing is with the settings here. So we were in settings actually, right? So inside settings, you will find apps. So you can literally control the apps. Like there is a lot of things you can do here. I'll be making different videos so that you can watch and change accordingly. You have the system app settings here, and inside that you'll find call settings. Now call related settings, you have another incoming call settings. Now there are some sensor based things here. Let's say the phone keeps ringing and you want to quickly silence the ringer, you can just flip your phone on the table or on your lap, then the ringer gets silent automatically. Similarly, you have quiet ringer when lifted, so it's the quite the opposite. Like if you have kept your phone on the table and it starts ringing, if you just pick up the phone, it gets silent so that you can just answer the call whenever needed, so it doesn't have to ring it quite often, right? Because you know you have lifted the phone. So there is a phone incoming, you know that, so it gets silent automatically. Similarly, you have the increasing ringtone volume, which means gradually the sound increases. Like if you have some people surrounding you and you don't want that ringtone to be too loud, so gradually the ringtone volume gets increased if you have enabled this one. If you turn it off, suddenly the ringtone with whatever volume you have kept, it starts ringing, right? So this is another feature. There is flash when ringing. Let's say you have kept the phone far and the phone starts to ring, which you are not noticing it, but then the phone keeps flashing on the screen. Your eyes gets noticed quickly because there is something flashing over there on the table. So that's how you can enable these features. Again, it's based on convenience, like whatever you like, you can just go ahead and enable those things. That's how it is customizable. Again, guys, inside the advanced settings here, there are so many things actually you can do. You can go to quick responses, and by default, like if there is a call and you quickly want to respond them without attending the call, for example, these are the default thing. Again, you can customize this one. If I just tap ahead and whatever message you want to write quickly, you write. These are all like pre-written, so you can just go ahead whenever there is a call, you can just go ahead, swipe up and send these messages. Again, quickly moving on here, you have the settings, camera system settings. You can just go ahead to the camera and find these settings as well. Here there are few important things that you need to change. The first one is video encoder, H.265 high performance and H.264 high compatibility. These are two formats with the video encoding technique. Now what this does is, if you record your video with the H.264, like the video size will be more than what you get with the H.265. Now in order to save space, you can always keep recording with the H.265 inside the settings. So make sure you change H.264 to H.265. Now these days majority of the devices support H.265 as well, so it won't be an issue for you, especially if you are sharing the videos on mobile phone itself, like on WhatsApp or any other applications. So you can just go ahead and record your video with the H.265, so it saves a lot of space. Similarly, volume buttons function. Now what this does is, what your volume button acts when you open a camera. Like you can use it to smoothly zoom, or you can use it to shutter countdown, shutter, it acts as a shutter button, or you can change the volume using the volume key here. Like whenever you turn on the camera, let's say if I have kept to zoom here, so we will open the camera quickly. Now you will see here, if I just press the volume button, it is trying to zoom, right? So this is how you can use the volume rocker button. So again, customizable feature. So that's inside the settings here. Inside the camera setting, volume buttons function, you change it to zoom. Similarly, you have focus and shoot. Again, tap to focus, again tap on that to click a picture. That's how you change. And another important thing is this anti-banding feature. Always keep it to 60 hertz, so that won't flicker much while you are recording video or shooting a picture. So again, those are the things that you need to change on your camera settings. There is also watermark feature. Now you can actually turn this on and write custom watermark. You can write your name as a watermark for the picture. Otherwise, you can add timestamps on photos. You can just disable it as well if you don't want that timestamp to appear on photos. So guys, again quickly, there is one more thing that you can do with the camera settings, which is nice. I'll just show you quickly. So if you go to settings and lock screen, you'll find one option here. So launch camera. So double press the volume button to open the camera when the screen is locked, which means I have locked the screen right now. I'll just double press the volume button and quickly the camera opens up. So this is how you can open camera quickly if you want to take some shots really quick. So this is again a customizable feature which can be found in settings, lock screen, and then turn on the launch camera. So that's how quickly you can open the camera without even going to the home screen. There are actually so many things that you can customize with this phone, so I'll be making series of videos about that. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click on that like button and do share it with your friends. Alright guys, that's it in this video. I'll see you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.